Okey-dokey. Bit later today, but it's all right. Not enough people tune in for it to really matter at this point, so it's all good. So, the Arteza series continues. Episode 8, Acid Yellow. What number is that? 151, did I see? Yes. Still burning all the way through the yellows. 151. There it is. So, is this going to be like in the last episode, Jasmine Yellow? It looked, if I'm being honest, like a urine colour. Which colour is that? Jasmine Yellow 216. Was that it? Yeah. So there's Jasmine Yellow. That's the one I used last time. And it looked, I mean, look at it. It looks like pee, doesn't it? But then when I put it on the paper, it looked really bright. This one looks really bright. So does that mean we're going to be disappointed? Who knows? That's what, one of the interesting things about this series is seeing how it looks when you put it on paper. I did a colour chart for all these pens on paper, but I don't know, I feel like you need more than just a little square to see what it really looks like. But oh yeah, this looks good. Well, thought for a second I'd used the wrong one. That would have been disastrous. That's all good. I think what I'm going to do with this one is go a little bit more what I do with the Black Book series, just to be a bit freer, not really think about shapes. Just go in and see what's what. Getting a bit toasty in the weather these days. I am for anyone, I mean, obviously not everyone's going to be watching at this very second. No one's in at the minute, but if anyone decides to watch this later, they'll know if they watched any of the other streams that I do. That I've been working a bit more on the graffiti side of stuff to try and improve the lettering and make something out, basically combine a graffiti style with these kind of sketches. It's been a quite a difficult process. Like, it's quite hard to make a sort of standout graffiti piece in this style, like making the letters readable. It's been pretty challenging, so I thought, right, what I'll do, it's why I've not recorded any for a bit, because I've just not been happy with them. So what I've done is there's a Facebook group called Graffiti Sketches. There's a couple of others as well, but Graffiti Sketches seemed like a good place to start, where I posted some ideas I put down on a live stream and just asked for some feedback, and got a pretty good response. I think over 250 likes, I think, at this point, but loads of people came in and they were very kind about it. And there was some really good constructive criticism on it as well, saying, I mean, the main one, which is what I think I've said in previous streams that I've done about it, is making the letters more legible, readable. A few people did suggest that. Shout out to one particular poster, Justin Rose, who said that learn and sort of read more up on Wild Style, which I know of. I've known of since I got into graffiti, and it seems to be like a sort of foundational technique for any graffiti that you decide to do. And it was very kind to basically put his work in that comment to say, you know, I'm not some just random, you know, I've been doing it for a long time. And he posted his work and it was unbelievable. Like, I thought, Jesus. And he explained sort of how he got to his, like, it was a combination of Wild Style, 3D German. I learned a new graffiti, a graffiti style called, oh, what's it called? My mind's gone blank. What's it called? I've even got it here. Computer rock. So that was really helpful. So shout out to Justin. There was another one as well. I forget his name. I'll see if I can. Like, I'm still getting comments and likes even now. People are still sort of jotting stuff down. Yeah, a few people put that it was computer rock. Oh, there was, I forget the name. Sorry, hold on. I'll not waste time looking through it. But there was another artist, or another poster in there, who suggested that the main. So I posted one of my sort of main drawings. It was one of my sketchbook ones. It was the fourth one, so the orange one that I kind of whip out a lot as an example, because it's one of my favourite ones. And he said that would be really good as a background, which I think I did mention that when I was doing those streams. In another stream, I mentioned that make it more detailed in the background to make the words more sort of readable, because otherwise it just looks jumbled up. I gave the example of there was a blue one that I did that I liked, but the problem was the M was too jumbled up. Like, it didn't really look like anything. And that was one of the problems. So it was like separating the main letters from the more detailed piece in the background. And he even offered to just throw something up, like a 3D piece, and put it on just to see what it would look like. And I just thought, you know, that's incredibly generous for someone to dedicate their time to me. I thought that was excellent. What was his name? I am going to find him, because I just thought that was such a nice gesture. Oh, I can't find the comment because there's been quite a lot of comments of. AJ Ramos, that was his name. He just said, if you don't mind, I'll send you some ideas. And I just thought that was incredibly generous of him to do. I just thought he didn't need to do that, but he said he wanted to play with some ideas, so I'm like, yeah, sure. The more the merrier. Why is the quality of this picture is shocking. What is going on here? Have I changed the video settings? Output resolution 1440. No, nothing's changed. I don't know why it looks shocking. Gotta be honest, I don't know why. I'm just gonna have to make do, aren't I? Gonna have to make do. And then it zooms back out as it always does. And then my lamp's fallen over. What a disaster. I love this little lamp, but because there's no weight on the stand of it, you've gotta. You've got to be careful with it. Oh, I feel like the last couple of days have been really rough. Just I was struggling to get through. Yeah, this colour does look pretty decent. Quite bright. Always good to have a beverage on hand. I was meant to do it yesterday, but I'm gonna have to do it today. Shopping for some brand new paper. to start working on framing some stuff. I'm going to get a new light bulb for this room as well. It's that kind of horrible yellow. So I'm going to get a white one. Just to help with the lighting a little bit. Buy some oil while I'm at it, sort this blooming shower out. Yeah, I think what I'm going to do later today is I'm going to crack on with another. Well, crack on working on graffiti stuff. I might stream it. I don't know. I just don't know. See how I feel about it. Those being the only two options. Yeah, a lot of artists I follow on Instagram, they end up appearing in a graffiti magazine. I always think, could I ever produce any work that would end up in there one day? I wonder. Nothing wrong with being ambitious about it. Capybara. My son is obsessed with that song at the minute, and now I can't get it out of my head. I thought the yellows were going to be a bit dull, but the first few were a bit meh. The last couple have been okay. I mean, what's after this lemon yellow? bumblebee yellow. Starting to get a bit darker, transition into the reds after this. But probably what? This is the eighth one. Yeah, probably around about the 14th or 15th one. That's when colours will probably start noticeably getting darker. I linked a I put a link to my YouTube channel in the comments section of the Facebook group, but it's pending. All my other comments went through straight away, but that one's pending, so I'm not sure if I'm allowed to do it. But if I'm not, it's fine. But I thought it might be all right because it's a comment on my post, linking directly to my work. I don't know where I'm going to put the number yet on this one. I might put it top left. Not sure. And messages. Okay. Excuse me. Cleanest line, oops. Ow. It's actually more interesting than I thought. Wait, this is turning out. Oh, excuse me. I might crack on with this evening. I've still got my How I Draw series to finish. Like, I've got the base plan for it, but it's figuring out how to stitch it all together. I'm exhausted. little bit different, this one. Like, it looks like a network. Again, not intended it to be that way, but I quite like the way it's turned out. A 150 we'll put it up here. Excuse me. My nose would run like a tap. I actually don't mind this one at all. I thought I'd try a more sort of freer sort of way of drawing like I do in my black book, so I thought I'd give that a shot with this. Turned out okay. I think I'm just because I thought it's a good exercise in, I suppose I would say, grinding it out, because I mean there's a few reasons I've mentioned before why I wanted to do this, but I'm sort of learning at the minute that even though this is only the eighth one in, it's starting to feel grindy. I think because I'm just grinding through all the yellow colours, and it's like I've drawn pictures with the same colour. I mean, they're obviously all slightly different, but like yellow doesn't show up the best on paper. I mean, the last two, this one and the one before, there's been a couple of others that have been all right. I think it's because yellow is not necessarily my favourite colour to draw with. Like, I don't mind using it as a highlight or like a filler or something, but to draw a main picture with, I don't know, it's just not a strong enough colour. So it is starting to feel a little bit grindy drawing pictures with yellow colours, but I wanted to try something a bit different with this. Almost like a, I don't want to say speed paint, but just to try and draw with a bit more flow. A bit more freedom instead of making it like really precise. Picture quality seems really cruddy for some reason. Let's have a look at that. See, I don't mind that at all. I might just darken in a few more areas. Look. Do you know what? I think I'm going to leave that there. I actually really like that. And I didn't think I would. Let me add a bit more here. Like, I didn't have any ideas at the start. I thought, how do I want to play this one out? And then I thought, well, the whole point of the black book was just to be a bit more free. Like, just don't think, just draw, see what happens. And that's kind of how I've approached this one. And as it turns out, it's come out quite good. It's different to my other ones. Okay, it looks like there's a bit more freedom in it. I'll just fill out some spaces. Yeah, I think I'm quite happy with that. Looks pretty good. Let's sign it off. Nice one. Well, no one joined today. That's all right. I was a bit later than I normally would. It felt good to just get my head down. Yeah, I quite like that. I didn't think I'd like it as much as I do, but good stuff. Well, for anyone who watches this in the future, this is a series I do every Friday, 12 o'clock normally, is when I start the stream, 12 o'clock UK time. I don't know, I may pop in with an extra stream at the weekend, but until then, I'll sign off with that one, and I'll see you later.